Hello and welcome to another video on how to use MobiLock for your iOS devices. This is the first part of two video part tutorial where you would see how to use the volume purchase program and MobiLock together. Volume purchase program is a tool by Apple which helps you to install and distribute paid applications using your MDM provider. Volume purchase program helps you to silently install applications without the need for an iTunes account on the device. In this video, we will see how to set up VPP or how to make MobiLock the VPP manager for your VPP program. For the demo purposes, I have already enrolled one device onto my dashboard. So, once you log into your dashboard, navigate to the device enrollment section, click on Apple Setup. As you would see, I have already set up my APNS as this is the first and basic step to start with Apple device enrollment. DEP is only required if you want to use DEP devices with MobiLock. Otherwise, you can directly go to the VPP tab, click on Add VPP Account. Once you click here, there will be a link that will take you to get the VPP token. Click on that link. This link will guide you to the VPP portal of the Apple. At this point of time, MobiLock only supports distribution of business applications. So click on Go to the Business Store. Log in with your credentials. If you have two-factor authentication enabled, you might be asked for a two-factor authentication. I have skipped that. Once you're logged in, click on the account name. Click on Account Summary. Here, there will be an option to download the token. Click on Download Token. Navigate back to the MobiLock dashboard. Click on Next here. Drag and drop the token here. Click on Next. And here you go. The VPP setup is complete. Once the VPP setup is complete, as you would see, we would display the organization name, when the certificate expires, and what is the status of sync. This is the step where MobiLock is querying the Apple that what are the volume purchased program apps that you have. Once the sync completes, the number of VPP apps you have will be displayed here. Let me refresh the page. Let me navigate back to the VPP. As you would see, the sync is complete and I have retrieved the one application that I have. You can click on this to see the applications that you have. Now, why does this application appear here? Let's go back to the VPP portal. As you would see in the VPP portal, if you go to the view purchase history, I had already purchased an app, Brew Survey, and I had purchased for 5 licenses for this. That's why this app appears in MobiLock. Say for example, in your volume purchase program, you want to buy a new app. Let's see how that works. Go to the VPP home here. Let's search for an app. Let's call it Dropbox. Once you search for Dropbox, click on Dropbox. Enter the amount of licenses that you want. Say for example, I want 5. Click on Review Order and click on Place Order. If Dropbox would have been a paid app, then you would have to complete the payment formalities so that you can purchase the 5 licenses for Dropbox. Let me place the order. Once this is done, you can come back to MobiLock dashboard. We automatically syncs the VPP apps every 6 hours. If you want to force a sync, you can click on Sync Now. Once the sync is complete, you can refresh this page and see whether your app has appeared or not. Normally, it takes around 10 to 15 minutes for the app to be appearing here. Let me go back here. Let's see whether it has come. I can click on VPP apps and I click on sync now. Once the sync is complete, let me refresh the page. It looks like it is still taking time to fetch the Dropbox app. While it is syncing, let's go ahead and see what are the other options that I have on this page. This is the VPP asset management page. How do you get to here? Once you log into the dashboard, click on device enrollment, click on Apple setup, click on the VPP tab, click on the number of devices. Once you go here, you would see all the VPP apps that you have here. It'll show you the ones that you have, the licenses that are consumed, whether this app is device assignable or not. MobiLock only supports device assignable VPP apps. You would see some actions around that app. Let's see what are those actions. When you click on settings, you can see the view assignments. That means where all this license is consumed. At this point, the app, none of the licenses are consumed. If the licenses are consumed, then you would see them displayed here. Then you can sync the licenses. This would be helpful for, say for example, you currently have 5 and you want to buy more. And you have, after you have bought the licenses, you can click on sync licenses so that MobiLock can know of the new licenses. Understand that an automatic sync happens every 6 hours. But if you want to force sync, you can use this option. You can also purchase more licenses from this section. When you click on purchase licenses, you will be directed to the VPP app where you need to complete the purchase formalities. Say for example, I want to add 5 more. Let's say I will just say 5 and click on review order and place the order again. Once this is complete, I can go to the purchase history and see what's the status of the order. Now, I can go back to my dashboard and here I can click on sync licenses. Once the sync licenses is complete, I need to refresh the page. Normally, it takes around 10 to 15 minutes for the newly synced licenses or the newly synced apps to appear here. This was about how to enroll or how to sync the free apps that you have purchased under VPP program. In the next video, we will see how to sync the paid apps or how to purchase the paid apps and then sync it on the dashboard. Hope this helps you complete the VPP setup and sync all your free apps. Thank you.